folks, as promised, here's the No Capo lesson for Payphone by Maroon 5. So if you don't have a capo, then this is the perfect lesson for you. And if you do have one of these, just throw it away and just learn these chords anyway. Okay? So it's just going to be a quick lesson. We'll go through the chords. I'm going to give you two ways as well. I'm going to give you just like a simple bar chord version. And I'm going to give you a version which is just a little bit trickier, but sounds a bit more melodic than just a normal bar chord version. Okay, so let's get started. Okay folks, so this is going to be your basic bar chord version. This is just going to be using the chords E, we're going to use B, we're going to use G sharp minor, and we're going to use F sharp as well. Okay, for the B chord, we're going to make a sus2 chord just because it sounds better and it's actually a little bit easier to play than a normal B major. Alright, so let's have a quick look at the chords. We'll flash them up on the screen now so you can see them. So we've got an E chord, that's just a normal open chord. We have a B sus2, which is going to be a bar shape. Okay, then we're going to have a G sharp minor, which is also going to be a bar shape, and the F sharp, which is also a bar shape. Okay, so this is really good bar chord practice, this. I'll walk you through the chords anyway. Okay, so our E chord, first of all, this is probably one that you've already learned, but if not, it looks like this and sounds like this. What we're playing is, we're playing all the strings, we're playing the open E here, the low E, then we're playing the second fret on the string below that with the middle finger here, we're playing the second fret below that with the third finger, then the first fret below that with the first finger, and then the two strings down the bottom here, the B and the E, are going to be played open. So we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 strings of strings. Okay, so that's our first chord. Our next chord is B sus2. Okay, B sus2 chord is a bar chord, okay? So for those of you who aren't quite sure about bar chords are made using our first finger here, bar down on the strings. Much like what a capo would do for us, okay? So we're kind of doing sort of like a human capo sort of thing here with the bar chords. So we're pushing our strings down with this first finger. Now we're going to be doing this starting at the second fret, okay? So we're going to take this first finger, and we're going to pop it down the tip of the finger close to the E string up the top here, but not pushing down on it, okay? And we're going to be pushing down all the pressure on the A string here. So that's our second here, second one looking down. And then we're going to push our fingers all the way down the string like that. So we should get a bar that goes down like this. So this is the second fret all the way down, just using our first finger. Okay? So it doesn't really sound that amazing yet, but we just have to add in a couple other fingers to get the sound of the chord that we're looking for. Now, I'm getting the pressure here from the bar by using the first finger here and the thumb at the back of the neck, and I'm creating like a sort of pincer here. I'm trying to like kind of crush the neck in between so that I'm getting enough pressure down on the strings. You can see here, I don't know if you'll be able to see here actually. But you're going to push in, so this is around the neck, and you're going to be squeezing in like that to get the pressure that you're looking for, okay? So, we've got that second fret bar, and we're going to add in, on the D string, we're going to add our third finger at the fourth fret there, and we're going to add our pinky underneath that on the fourth fret on the G, okay? And we're going to strum down from the A string, so we should get this sound. Okay, so it's a really nice chord. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like so. Okay, so that's our B sus2. Sounds quite nice. Okay, so that's our second chord. Now, what we're going to do with this shape, just to try and help you guys get the changes faster, is we're going to be moving this shape up a string and along two, okay? So this is the way I would think about it. I would think about moving up the way, like this. So you're going to move everything up a string, okay? And then you're going to move it along two frets. So 1, 2, right? Now when we do that, what we'll end up with is a G sharp minor chord. G sharp minor chord is the 4th fret on the E here, 6th fret with the 3rd and pinky on the D and the A and D strings respectively there, okay? So you get like a sort of power chord shape. And then this finger is barring down the 3 other strings, the G, B and E, like that, okay? So we should get this sound for a G sharp minor. Okay, it's quite a sad one, that one. Okay, that's our third chord. Now to move to our last chord, our F sharp major, what we're going to do is we're going to do basically what we did before, but just moving back. So instead of moving forward two, we're just going to move back two. We're going to go like this. 1, 2, right? This would lead us to F sharp here. But what we're going to do on the F sharp is we're going to add in this middle finger here on the third fret of the G. Okay, so if we strum that down, it's going to give us a major chord. It's going to give us F sharp major. Okay, and that's all the chords that we need. So if we strum them through again, we've got our E chord. Now remember, if you want to go back and like reference the chord diagrams for this, by all means, go back, pause the video, go back. Right, but here we go, here's our E. Then we've got B sus2. Then we're going up to G sharp minor, so that's upper string and a long 2. 1, 2. That'll give us that sound. And then we're going to go back 2 frets and put our middle finger down here on the 3rd fret of the G. And that'll give us that chord there. Okay? So that's the 4 chords that you need for this song. Alright, so now you've got these chords together, what we'll quickly do is we'll go and have a look at the strumming pattern. Right folks, here's our strumming pattern. Now, depending on how you want to play this song, lots of people do different like sort of covers and different ways of playing this, you can play the strumming pattern fast or slow. So you could just play through downstrokes. Like that sort of idea. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right, that's sort of an easier way of doing it. Or you can play a sort of upbeat one, okay? So I'm going to show you an upbeat pattern just to play along with it. Alright, so this is how the upbeat pattern is going to sound along with the chords. Okay, so you can see what we've got is we've got a repeating strumming pattern for each chord. So it's not changing, it's just staying the same for every chord. Our strumming pattern is going to go like this. Okay, it's going to go... Okay, so that is down, down, up, up, down, 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 up. Okay, slow that down. It's going to be down, down, up, up, down, 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 up. Okay, we'll do that once more. It's down, down, up, up, down, 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 up. Now, if we do that in every chord, we'll do it nice and slow. Down, down, up. Up, down, 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 up, down, down, up, up, down, 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 up, down, down, up, up, down, 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 up, down, down, up, up, down, 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 up. Okay, so that's our strumming pattern, and if we speed it up, we get a little bit more of a sort of upbeat sort of feel to it, okay? But bear in mind, this is, depending on the way you want to play this song, you can play that any strumming pattern as long as you can make it fit the sort of style that you want. If you want to do it slow, like sort of medium pace, or faster, okay? So, that concludes the sort of easier version. So, we'll move on to the little bit of a trickier version, the way that I would probably play things if I was going to be like covering the song. Okay, folks, so... this is a little bit of a trickier version to practice. The reason I'm giving you this is to give you a little bit of like cohesiveness to the chords, okay? And by that I mean that the bar chords, they sound great when we play them, but they do sound a little bit disjointed because they're always moving out of positions, you know? And when we are playing sort of open style chords, they all have like usually a common note that can associate most of them with, or they're all in the same sort of position off the fretboard. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a little like motif sort of thing where we're having the same note through all the chords. And that note's going to be this F sharp on the high E string here. Okay, now I'll quickly flash up the chords that I'm going to use here as well. These are a little bit more advanced, okay? So if you feel like this is too much, by all means just stop the video and you can go back and work on the other bar chords and get them together and they will sound great. But if you're looking for something a little bit trickier and a little bit more challenging, then stick with me here, okay? So our chords, we're going to have E add 9, okay? Now our E add 9, as you can see on the chord diagram there, sounds like that. It's just an E chord with the pinky added in on the high E string at that F sharp note that I was talking about. That note there. Okay, then we've got our B sus2, so that sounds like this. You can see your B sus2 is the same chord that we used for like the sort of easy version that we just did. Now, we're going to do a G sharp minor 7 like this. Okay, that's an excellent sounding chord, I do say so myself, okay? It's a really, really nice sounding one. And then we're going to have F sharp at 11, like this. Now, we're maybe going to try and use the thumb here, okay? Now, if you guys can't use the thumb, don't worry about it. Okay, we can leave out the thumb, but the thumb does add like a little bit of like more presence to the chord, okay? So, let's get into how we play these chords. Right, so first of all, the first chord is an E. Like this, okay? So that's regular bog standard E. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take the pinky and pop it down at the second fret on the E string. That gives us E add 9. Like so. Okay, does that make sense? Hopefully it does. Like so. Nice sounding chord. Now we're going to do B sus 2. I'm going to do this. Normal sort of power chord shape, starting at the second fret on the A string there, but we're barring down this first finger all the way down. So strum from the A string, 2, 4, 4, 2, 2 would be the fret numbers. Okay, now our G sharp minor 7, what we're going to do for this is we're going to be using our middle finger here and up like so. Okay, now this middle finger is going to be sitting on the low E string here. Okay, and then what's going to happen is this A string is going to get muted out and we're going to be playing the 4th on the D and the 4th on the G with our 3rd and pinky fingers, okay? We're going to skip past the B string, I'm going to leave that open, and we're going to stretch down for this F sharp note again. So once again, we're using the same F sharp note. Okay, so that's our G sharp minor 7. Like so, okay, that's a really nice sounding chord there. Then we're going to keep that note there, and we're going to build up a sort of F sharp here, okay? Now, hopefully you guys will remember the F sharp shape. But we're going to be doing this a little bit different. We're going to keep this open B above this F sharp note on the high E string. Okay, we're going to keep the open B. We'll play the 3rd fret on the G with our middle finger. The 4th fret is going to be played by the pinky on the D and the 3rd finger on the A. And if we can, we're going to bring our thumb around up to the 2nd fret note up here. And that'll give us this sound, okay? So that's F sharp at 11. Great sounding chord. Okay? Now, strumming pattern wise, we'll just use the same strumming pattern as we did for the first part. Okay? So if you want to reference the video back there, you can go and have a quick look at the strumming pattern. I'm going to just go ahead and play the chords through for you with the strumming pattern, and you can hear how they sound all together. Okay? Our lesson. So hopefully you guys found this helpful and you can now strum through this song without worrying about a capo. Alright, so if you liked the video, press the like button down there, that's it. And if you really liked the video, you can press the subscribe button there and check out some of my other videos as well. Alright, thanks again for watching guys, I'll see you in the next video.